No, this... Yeah, this is winter season. Oh my god, this is nutty. This camera's insane. What the fuck is happening? There we go, we got it on the two prettiest people in the scene. Vince, you know, sitting next to a young kid, we don't usually allow that because of Vince's past of calling kids maybe very attractive. Let me reset all these scores, like I should have been doing instead of setting up a fucking webcam. I don't know why I'm still commentating, I'm actually an awful commentator. Matthew, I really want to go play Friendlies, but I'm so... Okay, this is... And player one. The blue. Oh, okay, because that one doesn't use custom expense, I'm pretty sure. Let me do why it's like some quality. Okay. These two teams. Okay, match right now, looking pretty even. Right, so he's doing an excellent job of going away, and not taking a lot of percent. I think the problem, like, I understand. Ooh, double F smash, looking for it, not quite getting it. Oh, that's heavy, hit him a lot, but Strike doesn't get anything off there, doesn't go for an up air, just goes for the nice border. Ooh, F smash. He's been getting a lot of percent for those, filling up. What? You guys beat Neon Ragnar?
Yeah.
Beat the... Frio? I heard shit happening. The monster smells like bubblegum. Bubblegum. This smells like bubblegum. Right now, pretty even game. Ooh, so there's looking scary off the top. If everyone basically at 2% now, and okay. There we go. AMAC and Strike both losing their stocks. Now let's see who can die first between Vince and DJKK, the Sword Masters. Oh, Vince gets them there. AMAC getting carried across the stage by Strike. He has insane combos on Bowser Jr. It's really bad. She can just hit him a lot because she hits him from underneath and get those like soft hits on the heart and just keep it. Ooh, F smash not happening. AMAC is going for that basically as much as he can. Oh, there we go. Finally cleans up the stock on DJKK. Red team still has a bit of a lead. Oh, Strike staying on the platform, but losing not doing much against DJKK P1. I think they're already down to their three last stocks. They really need to get some early kills on some of these. No team combo on Strike. That could have been almost a kill. Slayers needs a big lead on Striker Digi's Cool Kids, and then they need to get the other one too. Before either of them lose their stock in the game. Oh, up smash kills, doesn't kill both of them, but Vince now the only one left. 2v1. Ike, not exactly a great 2v1 character. He's got a big B sword to keep everyone out, but doesn't really have the speed to get around everyone. And she can set up a lot of combos. Up B gonna kill, yeah, just a raw up B. Alright, there we go. Alright, both these guys have some different characters that I know they could bring out. I'm really not sure if Bowser Jr. and Ike is that great a team composition. I feel like it's actually awful. I feel like Bowser Jr. and Ike. That's terrible. Strike is just gonna combo them forever, and then Meta Knight's gonna combo them forever, and then they'll be dead off the top. Yeah. But they're sticking with it, they're sticking with it, they felt it. They were doing pretty good for a lot of the game, but DJ Cool Kids and Strike really did look like they were, you know, kind of dominating a lot. FD, the counter pick, maybe they feel something here.
Ooh.
We're gonna see a lot of parts per second on FD. I know that Blanc loves the shade, but I know you're like, because I don't actually care about the next thing and Blanc is just like, I was just using it. Yeah, we're gonna see a lot of parts. Big problem with the stage is that Strike, even though he was using platforms to run away a lot, when he doesn't have these platforms to run away, he's still just as strong. He can just stand in place and needle a lot and hit a lot of people with needles. They are so good on the stage. And while the range nerf affected her a lot in singles, in doubles, you almost are never going to need full stage needles, right? There's always going to be someone on your side of the stage who's going to be though they do make the less saves. Right now, game's pretty even. Everyone kind of at kill percent. Yeah, that up tilt on Sheikah is going to kill that early. That was really good by Vince to recognize that he was still that early. That was so scary by Sheik. I don't know why he goes that low. Bowser Jr. has a lot of jank off stage and stuff he can do with that up beat. And that was straight going last month already. So unless they do clean up these stocks really fast and then do some really good work. Like even if they clean up these stocks, it's still even stocks and DJ Cool Kid is at 119%. Yeah. Now it's even stocks. The DJ Cool Kid dive. 4-2, it would be even if it weren't for that strike SD, so you can still see, you know, the stage is obviously working out for Vincent AMAC, you know. Even without the SD, they'd still be in the lead here. It's gonna be hard for Red to make a comeback. Oh, AMAC! Trying to avoid Mennonite off stage, trying to avoid getting stage spiked by back air or something, but this goes way too low. And now the stocks are completely even. Blue had a bit of an advantage in terms of percent. Had them off stage there for a second, but now it's reversed into a double edge situation against Blue. And that getting comboed. See, oh, Strike isn't getting anything off that forward tilt. We're gonna try and 2D one Doug. No, he just keeping stage control with those needles. That's the strength of them. They just keep everyone away. Working for a kill. If he ever gets this next kill between, oh, there's a raw Bianca, and the close match on Sheik. Now it's completely even once again. That up there, almost getting close to killing. Such a good combo on there for Sheik. See what they can do. They really need to clean up DJ's stock. Oh, he goes on stage. No punish for Mike. He's keeping out Sheik, and that's too high to punish. Oh. Oh, Ram-Ham, no, not gonna connect. Uppy kills! Oh, that kills. Uppy Junior, that was so unfortunate. He was up in the air trying to do something. Mennonite's just so strong above people. Now, Vincent, AMAC in a huge disadvantage. Unless he clean up his stocks so fast on. Oh, there's the up tilt. Now, Vincent, the advantage, actually. DJ Cool Kid's getting a little too antsy and going in a little too hard when he doesn't really need to. Strikes, or Sheik is really good at playing, or going in and doubles, but, you know, so far I haven't seen Strike do that, so I was like, so it's not surprising that DJ Cool Kid's winning, though it is obviously not a good decision. Now the 1v1, Strike doing a good job just keeping Vince out with needles. These are two very high level singles players. Vince, though, hasn't been able to get a hit. Once he does, changes the whole game. Oh, yeah, there we go. See, now he's off stage. Even just one of those big swords. Oh, he goes with a forward smash. I don't know about that. It's really... Oh, up there. There we go. Okay. Oh, and that's still just the best of three. DJ Cool Kid and Strike. 2-0. Wow. That was pretty unfortunate for AMAC and Slayer. So they're looking so good in game two. That counter pick looked like it was working out for them. But then the SD... And that F tilt up air ending the game.